Good day everyone. So our topic for today is all about basic database. For the learning outline, we have a file-based systems, history of database, and database management system. For a file-based system is a collection of application programs that perform services for the users wishing to access information. Each program within a file-based system defines and manages its own data. Limitation of file-based system. One of the quickest and easiest ways to save data persistently so that you don't lose data when the computer is switched off or the program you are running are closes. Is it to save the data to a text or control save file. The files are great if you are just dumping the data, such as writing to an error log or saving configuration settings. But when you start to handle large amounts of data, or when you need to be able to edit or search the data, you run into problems. The limitations. First is the text data must be read sequentially, which means that that if you have thousands or even millions of items in the file, it is going to take a long time to read the data. Number two, there is no inbuilt search function, so you must search through the data manually. Number three, you often cannot edit a single line, you must rewrite the entire file. Continuation. Number four, filtering is slow and difficult. You must import all the data into a dimensional array and filter the data from there. Number five, because there is no way of establishing relationships between the data entered, there is often large amounts of redundancy in the data or duplication. Number six, this means that file-based systems are often not the best solution, and a relational database is more appropriate. History of database system. Information processing drives the growth of computers as it has from the earliest days of commercial computers. In fact, automation of data processing tasks predates computers. Punch cards, invented by Hermann Hollerith, were used at the very beginning of the 20th century to record U.S. census data. And mechanical systems were used to process the cards and the tabulate results. Punch cards were later widely used as a means of entering data into computers. Techniques for data storage and processing have evolved over the years. First generation. Hierarchical model, information management system, or IMS. Number two, network model, conference on data system languages, CODASIL database task group, DBTG. Limitation, complex program for simple query, minimum data independence, no theoretical foundation. Second generation, relational model, ERCODD, DB2, Oracle. Limitation, limited data modeling. And the last one is the third generation, object relational DBMS, object oriented DMS. Database management system. A database management system, or DBMS, is a software package designed to define, manipulate, retrieve, and manage data in a database. A DBMS generally manipulates the data itself. The data format, field names, record structure, and file structure. The management responsibility for DBMS encompass, number one, information within the databases. Number two, the process applied to databases such as access and modification. Number three, the database's logic structure. Number four, DBMS also facilitates additional administrative operations such as change management, disaster recovery, compliance, and performance monitoring, among others. Components of DBMS software. A DBMS is primarily a software system that can be considered as a management console or an interface to interact with end management databases. The interfacing also spreads across real-world physical systems that contribute data to the back-end databases. The OS network, software, and the hardware infrastructure is involved in creating, accessing, managing, and processing the databases. Number two, data. DBMS contains operational data, access to database records, and metadata as a resource to perform the necessary functionality. The data may include files with such as index files, administrative information, and data dictionaries used to represent data flows, ownerships, structure, and relationships to the other records or objects. Continuation number three. Procedures. While not a part of DBMS software, procedures can be considered as instructions and using DBMS. The documented guidelines assist users in designing, modifying, managing, and processing databases. Number four, databases languages. These are components of DBMS used to access, modify, store, and retrieve data items from databases. Specify databases schema, control users' access, and perform other associated database management operations. Types of DBMS languages include data definition languages or DDL, data manipulation languages or DML, database access language or DAL, and data control language or DCL. Number four, query processor. As a fundamental component of DBMS, the query processor acts as an intermediary between users and the DBMS data engine in order to communicate query requests. When users enter an instruction in SQL language, the command is executed from the high-level language instructions to a low-level language that the underlying machine can understand and process to perform the appropriate DBMS functionality. In addition to instruction, parsing, and translation, the query processor also optimizes queries to ensure fast processing and accurate results. Runtime Database Manager, a centralized management component of DBMS that handles functionality associated with runtime data, which is commonly used for context-based database access. These components checks for user authorization to request the query, process the approved queries, devises an optimal strategy for query execution, supports concurrency so that multiple users can simultaneously work on the same database, and ensure integrity of data record into the database. Database manager, like the runtime, database manager that handles queries and data at runtime. The database manager performs DBMS functionality associated with the data within databases. Database manager allows a set of commands to perform different DBMS operations that include creating, deleting, backup, restoring, cloning, and other databases maintenance tasks. The database manager may also be used to update the database with patches from vendors. Database engine. This is the core software component within the DBMS solution that performs the core functions associated with data storage and retrieval. A database engine is also accessible via APIs that allow users or apps to create, read, write, and delete records in databases. Reporting. The report generator extracts useful information from DBMS files and displays it in structured format based on defines and specification. This information may be used for further analysis, decision-making, or business intelligence. Benefits of DBMS. DBMS was designed to solve the fundamental problems associated with storing, managing, accessing, securing, and auditing data in traditional file systems. Traditional database applications were developed on top of the database, which led to challenges such as a data redundancy, isolation, integrity constraints, and difficulty managing data access. A layer of abstraction was required between users or apps and the databases at physical and logical level. Data security. DBMS allows organizations to enforce policies that enable compliance and security. The databases are available for appropriate users according to organizational policies. The DBMS system is also responsible to maintain optimum performance of querying operations while ensuring the validity, security, and consistency of data items updated to a database. Data sharing, fast and efficient collaboration between users. Data access and auditing, controlled access to databases, logging associated access activities allow organizations to audit for security and compliance. Continuation, data integration. Instead of operating island of database resources, a single interface is used to manage databases with logical and physical relationships. Abstraction and independence. Organizations can change the physical schema of database system without necessitating changes to the logical schema that govern database relationships. As a result, organizations can upgrade, storage, and scale the infrastructure without impacting the database operations. Similarly, changes to the logical schema can be applied without altering the apps and services that access the databases. Uniform management and administration. A single console interface to perform basic administrative tasks makes the job easier for the database admins and IT users. And for